Eric Bakker, naturopath. Is milk good for gut health? Could open a can of worms here. It's like saying, is it good to be a Catholic? Is it good to be a Muslim? Is it good to be, you know, a Christian? What is it good to be? Is it good to be an atheist? Well, it's a belief system, isn't it? Milk's a bit similar, but milk does have some science behind it, you know, regarding the good or the bad. Many people will probably comment on this video saying you're a fool. Humans aren't meant to drink cow's milk because only calves are meant to drink that, you know. Babies are meant to drink that. So, yeah, you could say that. I mean, you could say that about a lot of foods. We could just, why don't we go further and say the bananas are meant for chimpanzees and, you know, Coca-Cola is meant for humans because milk's made for cows. In fact, I did actually see that on a billboard sign somewhere. I think it was on Instagram or something from the 70s, where Coca-Cola actually did a big billboard telling people not to drink cow's milk, but to drink Coke, because Coke is made by humans for humans. I mean, this goes to show how dumb some companies can be. Anyway, if you get milk from a cow that's raw, unpasteurized, and it's been feeding on grass, that cow, on good grass, hopefully not grass that was sprayed with glyphosate 6 months before, hopefully grass that wasn't peppered with DDT 50 years before, because research is also showing that if you put these organochlorine compounds on the soil, the cows are going to get that in their system anyway, and then you're going to have milk with DDT in it. So, but if you get proper, I'm talking about organic milk, particularly from a Jersey cow rather than a Friesian, you know, the black and white Friesian cows, you know, because when you start looking at Friesians, you're going to have a bit of an issue there with the casein. So you've got the A2 milk, for example, the A1 protein's being taken out. And it's very popular in New Zealand now. With Jersey cows, I believe, you don't really, you know, the browner cow, you don't really have that issue so much with the A1, A2. So why would you drink milk that's been doctored with or played around with to take proteins out? You can either tolerate milk or you can't tolerate milk. That's how I see it. Many people can tolerate milk to a level and then they can't tolerate it beyond that. I'm like that. I can tolerate small amounts of milk as long as it's organic and proper cow's milk. So we're talking milk that's very high in immunoglobulins, that's high in oligosaccharides, that's very high in good quality amino acids. We're talking a quality product, and we're talking like real cow's milk. The taste, the texture, everything about milk that's straight from the cow is not to be compared with milk from a plastic bottle from a factory. So let's get that clear from the start. I'm also not talking about drinking gallons of this stuff a day, but small quantities. Studies I've looked at show a dramatic increase in bifidobacteria from people who do consume good quality milk. But even studies from China are showing, I read an interesting study where they just got a whole lot of people from a village, put them on milk powder mixed with water and fed them that for a period of time, and also found that the bifidobacteria went up. And no doubt that will be pasteurized, homogenized, you know, powdered milk. So milk does confer benefits. But milk also has a high potential for an allergy. It's one of the most allergy of all prone of all foods. If your digestive system's in great shape, like mine, you can probably tolerate milk to a degree, right? But I don't like people consuming like ice cream laden with sugar, sweetened condensed milk like my dad used to drink, you know, cans of the stuff because he wanted the sugar. So when we get a nice product like a natural thing like milk and doctor it and stuff it up and stick it in a factory, we're going to get a problem. This is when we're looking more at getting serious inflammation from this type of junk that people call food. So same with sugarcane. If we get sugarcane from nature, you know, I've been up in North Queensland in Australia myself. I've seen the cane, you squeeze it, you chew on it, you drink it. Doesn't create dental caries. It's full of magnesium. It's full of minerals. But when we give it to some stupid guy in a white coat and put it in the factory and we create this white powder, it's like radioactive crap. It ruins your health. It's called sugar. Okay, so we get hold of something natural and we turn it into crap. So don't confuse the picture with the junk. That's what I'm talking about. I'm talking about the real natural thing. Milk does have a good effect on health. And particularly when you get hold of a quality milk and then convert that into kefir or yogurt, because then you're extending the benefits even further. Okay, so the lactose in the milk confers the ability for the body to build the bifidobacteria. And we're talking about a good level of bifidobacteria. So if your gut is able to tolerate cow's milk and you have a low lactobacillus, low bifido count particularly, it's worth trying to add small amounts of raw, unpasteurized, unhomogenized cow's milk into your diet. I believe also the same will hold true with goat milk, buffalo milk, and camel milk. All those milks are quite good, but small amounts we're talking. We're not talking gallons a day, okay? But then you're going to get a problem. So there you have it. I'm not averse cow's milk. You know, I'm not for or against it. I'm sort of on the fence, and I think that's something that everybody needs to look at themselves. But if you've got access to that raw material, you certainly want to give it a go. Thanks for tuning in.